Welcome, everyone. Today's talk will be Mini Apps Unleashed. I am Andy. I lead the developers team here at Tools for Humanity. So all things SDK, if you're building anything on the WorldCoin infrastructure, you're probably touching one of the products that we build. And so today's talk is going to be diving deeper into Mini Apps, which you just heard announced in the keynote previously. We'll talk about why to build Mini Apps, what we're excited about, and then at the very end, we'll do a live demo and run a sort of experiment, so to say, with Mini Apps. Awesome. So for many of you who are familiar with the project, WorldCoin kind of exists on three main pillars. We have World App, of course, which is the main touch point for most of our users. It is a place to both transact with your financial assets, as well as somewhere that custodies all of your World ID credentials. In addition to that, for many of our users, it is not only their first, but their only touch point into Web3. And so for a lot of crypto developers, this is a very unique customer segment that you know they otherwise would not get access to. Additionally, we have World Chain, which is obviously a new product, but I kind of use it as an overarching term to describe all the crypto products that we hold here at WorldCoin. And so World Chain offers a lot of interesting things like writing smart contracts, doing actions on chain, obviously interacting with assets. And so it's going to become kind of the infrastructure backbone of all of the Web3 aspects of the project. And very lastly, World ID, of course, which is our privacy-preserving digital identity credential. What we've seen today is that that has kind of gone beefed up with World ID 3.0. And so all of the things that you can do, the things that you can prove, have been significantly increased. Now, for most of the developers, right now, all you can really interact with is World ID. And so if you used our IDKit SDK, you can generate privacy-preserving proofs to show that you're a unique human in a digital application. Now, that has been a very powerful SDK. And so far, I mean, we've seen a lot of different apps integrate with it, ranging from use cases like restaurant review platforms in Japan, systems to gate kind of gaming tournaments in the Web3 ecosystem, as well as offering things like one-time discounts for users with a World ID. However, we'd always gotten feedback from developers that they wished there was something a little bit more, that they could access kind of all the other pieces of the WorldCoin ecosystem as well. And so that's why we're super excited about Mini Apps, because Mini Apps sit at the center of all three of these products. And for the first time ever, you can access World Chain's crypto infrastructure. So via Mini Apps, you can write smart contract transactions. You can transact other assets beyond the assets that are natively supported within World App. And of course, World Chain has a lot of benefits in terms of ways where you can do uniqueness checks and priority transactions to make a better overall blockchain ecosystem. In addition, World ID has been beefed up. So the flow for using World ID is significantly more intuitive. If you use World ID previously, you'll know that it was a little bit confusing. You'd have a QR code that pop up, you scan with your phone, it generate the proof, you'd send it back over a bridge, and then the application would then verify it. And so obviously what happened is a lot of users would then churn, or they would find this process quite frictionful. And so with Mini Apps, that process is a lot easier, and you'll actually get to see that a little bit later. And of course, last but not least, World App. And so World App has incredible distribution. I'm sure you've seen from the keynote that the network is growing incredibly fast, and for good reason as well. And so for developers, this is kind of the first time you can get native real estate inside a World App, and all of the users that are coming back each month, all of the users that we are actively acquiring each month, will be able to be directed to your platform. And so it's a very sensible bet to invest in building in the WorldCoin ecosystem, because as you build your product, our network grows, and as a result, the natural distribution for your product is going to grow as well. And so just to hammer home that point on distribution, you can see here how exponential the growth has been in the past year, and that'll obviously continue to grow as we introduce new ways to verify and join the network as well, like the NFC credential that was just announced here. So we have 15 million users, 7 million of those verified, and these users come back to the app at about a high 90% frequency. And so users are constantly returning, and they're seeing your app. The app's page is the main screen that they're navigated to the first time they go there. And so for developers, this is an unprecedented opportunity to find distribution for your product, which for indie developers, small developers, is oftentimes an Achilles heel for actually getting your thing off the ground. So let's talk about mini apps a little bit more. What exactly are they? So mini apps are inherently web applications that are loaded inside a world app via WebView to offer a native-like experience. What that means is that you can take a standard web application that you have and all of its powerful functionality, integrate the Minikit SDK, and that supercharges your application to interact with World App and do a lot of interesting new functionalities, like using your World ID in a much more intuitive way, doing payment transactions, smart contract transactions, sharing your app, importing your social graph, sending notifications. So in essence, you get all of the really powerful benefits that you would expect in an application, but you inherit the World App distribution. And so out of all those commands, the two functionalities I really want to hammer home on today are first and foremost the differentiated verification. So World ID lets you do a lot of really interesting use cases and build some cool applications. I touched on them a little bit before, but obviously, like I said, there was a little bit of a UX friction for applications to really adopt this. Now with mini apps, all that happens is you initiate the proof, the phone generates the proof, and it sends it back to the mini app. And all the user sees is a modal just popping up, confirming it, and continuing on. And so using World ID in your application is a lot more intuitive and a lot better of an experience. In addition, we finally have the ability to access the financial assets within World App. This isn't something that developers have been constantly asking for, finding a way to leverage all of the money that was floating around in these World App wallets, as well as the money that they were receiving on a monthly basis. In addition to this, you were previously unable to interact with smart contracts using your World App wallet. With Minikit, for the first time, you can generate Web3 transactions directly on WorldChain, allowing basically any arbitrary transactions that you want to support. And so we've talked about the network, which is obviously a big piece for new developers, finding ways to find that takeoff energy to get their application off the ground. But at the end of the day, you guys are also building businesses. And the other key aspect is obviously the ability to make revenue. So World App wallets currently hold roughly $150 million worth of assets. And within the wallet ecosystem, about $15 to $50 million is spent per week. What this means is not only are you getting access to users, but there is actually a way to monetize these users. This is a very, very key fact, because just because you get users does not necessarily mean you're actually growing a business here. But the fact that these users have money to spend and are willing to spend it is a very, very good indicator that this is an ecosystem that is investable. And you compound this with the growth that I showed you earlier, obviously we'll see these numbers grow at a quite rapid rate, and it becomes a very sensible bet to build on the WorldCoin ecosystem as a third-party application developer. And so that's a brief overview about why you should build a mini app and all of the cool kind of functionalities that it enables. Now what we're actually going to do is a live demo. And so we shall see how it works. But essentially, what this demo is today is kind of touching on what I just mentioned before. So within mini apps, you have a unique way to leverage World ID. And you can kind of do a lot of fun little experiments, so to say. And so what we're building today is what we're calling the first ever never-ending story. And so essentially, what will happen is this will be a story that will be authored by every human in the world, so to say, obviously on the network. And then we will use GPT to stitch it together. And so it'll sound like a coherent story at the end, but basically everyone here has contributed to the story one time. And so we use World ID, obviously, to protect that. Because for instance, something like this, it wouldn't make sense to KYC someone, right? Like it's like a fun little game app. But World ID, obviously, in a privacy-preserving way, allows us to verify uniqueness. So we'll go ahead. I will open up my VS Code. So I will just show you guys what it looks like for now, since obviously, half of the battle is building the web application. The other half is actually integrating Minikit. A small screen where we have the seed of a story, and users can read this seed. Then they will sign in with their World ID, and then be able to actually contribute to this story. And once you've made your contribution, that will be the last time you can contribute. And then, collectively together, we will build out a story. So let me actually sign out real quick. I will show you what it looks like in a natural flow. So you have this QR code, obviously, that shows up. I would scan it with my phone. This is how the application communicates with the phone, what it wants to generate. You generate the proof, sends it back to the application. And if I configured everything correctly, drum roll. There we go. So now we are logged in. So what this means is I can actually contribute to the story now. So let's say, you know, Maya stepped carefully through the shimmering undergrowth, her eyes catching a flicker of light between the trees, pushing aside the leaves, she gasped in the clearing ahead. I won't read it all for you guys. You can see it here. I don't think you need my narration. But I think what we should do is enter the portal. So we're going to go ahead, enter the portal. And so firstly, I want to show you that this is a web application. And in this web application, of course, we have to have confetti. In this web application, we are additionally generating a story. And this is, you know, a very simple thing that you could build on your own with Next.js. And then now you see we've additionally contributed. And so after this, we won't actually be able to contribute again because in the database, we are protected by World ID. So now what I actually want to do is turn this into a mini app. And I want you to see just how quickly we can get that actually set up. And so here we have a developer portal application that we just made. Never ending story is what we're going to call it. We have our try it out ngrok URL, and we're going to go ahead and save our changes. So we set a redirect URL. There you go. Okay, so now we have our application. What we are going to go ahead and do is now copy this and add this URL here and create a QR code. And now if you could show my phone. So now we have a QR code, which is you know, just the app ID that I pasted in there. And so if I actually scan this QR code with my phone, it will go ahead and open up World App. So these are unlisted apps, so it's obviously going to be labeled as unsafe for now. I'm going to visit the site. Take a second here. And there we go. So I'm actually, I think, already logged in here since I just logged in on my computer. But if any of you guys want to participate afterwards, you can try it out. But here, you can see this application that I just had in about like 240 pixels, I guess. It is it's a little bit blurry. But here you can see the application here, and we can make a choice. So I will make a choice. And we can see the exact same flow that we just saw reproduced here. And there we go. I have my story contributed. And so if we have an audience member who has updated their app recently to the newest version, do we have any volunteers here? Otherwise, I will pick on. Oh, Jason, are you updated to the latest version? OK, cool. Can you scan this? Let me move this way. OK, there we go. If you go, so you logged in. Did you sign in? Or OK, can you make a choice now? OK, so there we see the existing story. You will make a choice. If you don't see the confetti, it's a bad sign. So try another. Either someone else already made a decision. You got the confetti? OK, perfect. Yeah, so now we see the story actually updated, and the choices are different. And so this story will continue to grow as each person participates. You'll all be able to make a choice once. And you can look back to see what contributor you were, and also see how the story evolves collectively as humanity, I guess. So for the first time ever, we have a story made in just about, you know, 10 minutes that has been contributed by everyone in the world. So fun little things that you can do with mini apps and World ID when it's natively baked in. And so this is a small example of kind of, you know, the type of things we're expecting to see with mini apps. So we can actually go back to the slides. You can remove my phone. If any of you guys want to play with it, I hope you scan the QR code. I'll show it again later at the end. But yep, so that has been a demo of the never-ending story. Of course, if any of you guys are interested in building mini apps or want to learn more, our docs are public. The SDK is public. You can join our Telegram group. If you have any questions about anything, I'll show this for a second. And then other people can try it afterwards. OK, it looks like our story has grown quite a bit. I am looking on my phone now. So yep, feel free to join the group. We'll share this around afterwards, so if you didn't get it. And then lastly, the disclaimer slide. But yes, make sure you update your app. Otherwise, you won't see the new release. Thank you.